from Stettin in the Baltic to Trieste in the Adriatic, an iron curtain has descended across the continent. Behind that line lie all the capitals of the ancient states of Central and Eastern Europe. Warsaw, Berlin.
In 1946, Winston Churchill raised the alarm, warning that tyranny was once again on the march in Europe.
And all these famous cities and the populations around them lie in what I must call the Soviet sphere. And all our subjects, in one form or another, not only to Soviet influence, but to a very high and in some cases increasing measure of control from Moscow.
Churchill's words drew criticism on both sides of the Atlantic. Neither the British nor the American people were ready for another war. But in the months since Potsdam, the Soviet Union was behaving more like an enemy than an ally. Joseph Stalin's Red Army had projected his authority throughout Eastern Europe. Bulgaria, Romania, Hungary, Czechoslovakia, Poland, and the eastern zone of Germany had come under the Soviet Union's sphere of influence. This was Stalin's buffer zone, assurance against future invasions. Initially, Stalin handpicked candidates to join coalition governments in these countries. But slowly, all opposing factions were eliminated until only the hardline communists remained. Many Eastern Europeans fled to escape the coming storm. Millions of others were forcibly deported. Scenes of mass expulsions were seared into the mind of one American intelligence officer. 27 boxcars packed and heading east to the Soviet work camps. Stalin continued to test the limits of the World War II Grand Alliance. He warned his people that war with the West was inevitable. Washington was at a loss to explain the hostility. What did the Soviet leader want? Were his ambitions limitless? The best answer came from George F. Kennan, who had spent years observing the Kremlin as an American diplomat stationed in Moscow. In an 8,000-word dispatch to Washington, now known as the Long Telegram, Kennan deciphered the Soviet riddle. At the bottom of the Kremlin's neurotic view of world affairs is the traditional and instinctive Russian sense of insecurity, he said. Stalin needed to present the outside world as hostile and menacing in order to justify his own bloody regime. This didn't mean that the Soviets desired war with the West, Kennan emphasized. Soviet leaders may be impervious to the logic of reason, but they would be highly sensitive to logic of force and would back down if confronted with strong resistance. A year later, writing under the pseudonym X, Kennan proposed a long-term, patient but firm and vigilant containment of Russian expansive tendencies. Kennan's idea of containment formed the basis of American Cold War policy for the next 50 years. Before long, it was put to the test.